Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Okay, everyone, our honor Dr. Profesor Ujang or the Dean of EMA, Vice
Thank you.
Dean and Director of ICO if there, and then the Dean of Faculty of Forestry and Environment, Dr. Naris. Let me have my slide, please. I want to share first. Can I share my slide, please? Still cannot be opened by one participant only. Could you change multiple?
All right, would you like
Yeah, I will try. Okay. Okay, please a moment. Stop. Yeah. Okay, it's already there.
Yes, sir. Already there.
Yes. Yeah. Sorry. First of all, I want to say our honor for Dean and Vice Dean of the FEMA faculty, and then also the students, all the students, the participants of this summer course. Good day. I'm Afra. I'm represented the Dean of Faculty of Agriculture. And then I want to share a little bit about the agriculture and the use the agriculture in tourism object. So because I'm from landscape architecture, so I will combine the agriculture and then the tourism in agriculture, as we call agro-tourism. For definition and understanding that agriculture is the science of practice farming, including cultivation, yeah, and for the growing of crops in the land and the rearing of animal to provide food and other products. So for the resources of agriculture, of course, is land and on-farm buildings, and the equipment of facilities, farmer, and of course, the technology. So in this case, we will have three kind of agriculture based on technology implemented. First is traditional agriculture. This is agriculture that use the technology and management system by follow the almost natural system. This is a common in exist in Indonesia village. And then the second one is a modern agriculture, use modern technology, of course, and modern management system, usually make environmental engineering to cultivation or growing, for example, greenhouse, shading house, hydroponic system, etc. And the third one is higher agriculture technology and manage with efficiency. But this is, of course, high risk, need time, and of course, need money to implement it, this higher agriculture technology. Then now I want to show you the modern and versus traditional agriculture. So you can see that the agriculture with traditional method. We use cattle, yeah, to prepare the land, but the modern one use the machine, tractor. This is also the sample. The seed by the farmer, and this one by the machine. So this is a very different method in agriculture activities. Now I want to show you a little bit about the agrotourism. Why we call agrotourism? Because the tourism in this time, the area of tourism, this planning by agriculture resources. For example, we use plant cultivation land to become a object of the agrotourism, and then livestock, grazing, rangeland, fisheries, and also a mixed farm area. And we use agriculture village for the agrotourism area, and we use the activities of farmer with the community's lifestyle, with very unique in agriculture, and also plantation area with agriculture processing plant, urban agriculture, and others. So this is, for example, we use land. This is for the in the picture. This is in Indonesia, in Manggarai, Flores, Indonesia. This is the natural paddy field, looking like spider pattern. Yeah, in every farmer, every family have this land, and then they cultivate it together. Yeah, this is in our, so you can maybe sometimes see there, become a tourist. Yeah, yeah, this is using of land resource of agriculture as an object of agrotourism. Also, this one is for example, the cattle as an object for agro-edutourism area. So we this is very interesting, of course, feeding the cattles, yeah, and see the how the farmer sell the cattles. This is become the object of agrotourism also, yeah. And then of course, festival production in agrotourism activities. This is very interesting activity, and we can use the farmer garden, yeah, in surrounding the their house, and also the plantation of in vegetable area. Yeah, that's all I think. So this is for glance for agriculture resources that used as objects in agrotourism. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Dr. Afra. Maybe after this, we will have Associate Professor Naresworo as the Dean of Faculty of Forestry and Environment. Please, Associate Professor Naresworo, the time is yours.
Thank you, Sasabina. Can you hear me?
Yes, but maybe the volume is a little low.
Check. It's okay.
Okay.
Thank you for your time opportunity. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum. Honorable Dean Professor Ujang Surmawan, Dean of Human Ecology, Faculty of Human Ecology, Director of International Program Professor Iskandar Zulkarnain, Vice Dean in Human Ecology, Dr. Titi Amanah and Dr. Katrin Rosita, and also Vice Dean from Faculty of Agriculture, Dr. Afra Magdalu. Thank you for the opportunity. Sharing summer course committee and also our lovely students. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good morning, good afternoon to everybody. Alhamdulillah, praise over the presence for LDC, because on this day we can be present and gather today. May I introduce myself. My name is Naresh Warun Groho. You can call me Nares. It is a great pleasure and honor for me as Dean of Faculty of Forestry and Environment ITB University to give the presentation in the Summer Course 2020 that had by Faculty of Human Ecology, IPB. The topic of the summer course is Learning for Human Development and Natural Resources Towards Sustainability and International Perspective. I'm very happy that over 48 participant students from 7 countries can meet here virtually to share knowledge, ideas, and also learn together. Even though not directly meet face to face, but through this Zoom cloud meeting platform. This pandemic is still so terrifying, so please all stay safe and healthy wherever you are. Let's start this presentation. As we know that the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development adopted by UN Nation members stated in 2015 provide a shared blueprint for peace and prosperity for people and the planet now and into the future. At this heard the 17 sustainable development goals, which are urgent call for action by all countries, developing and developed countries, including Indonesia, as a global partnership. They recognize that ending poverty and other deprivation must go hand in hand with strategies that improve health and education, reduce inequality, and spur economic growth, all while tackling climate change and working to preserve our ocean and also our forest. So Faculty of Forestry and Environmental also would contribute the role to SDGs, especially in management of Gunung Walat Educational Forest. We have Gunung Walat Educational Forest in Sukabumi. Next, please. This is our location. The legal status is State Forest Area for Special Purposes. And we have forestry ministry decree, only small forest area with 359 hectares surrounded by various land use in the developed area. If you have a chance to visit, this is a 50 kilometer short part of Bogor in Sukabumi, and or 90 kilometer from Jakarta. In this area is about 460 until 700 above sea level. The area is established and managed by Faculty of Forestry and Environment IPB since 1968. Next is this is our management perspective. The vision is creating Gunung Walat Educational Forest, or we call it Gunung Walat GWEF, as a medium to implement the Tri Dharma, perguruan tinggi in Bahasa, or Tri Mandate for education, research, and community services in international standard for achieving sustainable forest management. Our mission is three mission: achieving sustainable forest management in this area, realizing the effective implementation of education and research and science and technology, development of forest resource management and the environment. And the last is developing partnership between Gunung Walat Educational Forest and various stakeholders and implementation of community or public services. Next, we have also a general policy. This is some of them is sustainable forest management for ecological, economic, and social to support the Tridharma Faculty of Forestry. We have also activities plantation management without cutting tree or zero cutting, no intentional tree cutting. We have only maintain the tree. We have also model management of environmental services and tourism, and model management of non-timber forest products such as resin products for tapping the tree to produce the resin. And small-scale sustainable forest management model which can finance itself. And also this location is a model of FMU, Forest Management Unit, the smallest management unit that can be managed effectively and sustainable and efficient. The scope of management, next please, is a three division. This is for ecological management, eradicating policy, and management of forest resources, and also management of water resources and biodiversity conservation also. The second is production or economic management. We facilitate the student or the stakeholder to conduct the research study and education, and also utilization of non-timber forest products in the form of pine resin and copal, which is resin from agave tree, or payment for environmental services such as carbon project with the CSR from green company. And the third is for social management. It's the utilization of forest resources for household needs and also involvement of communities surrounding the Gunung Walat who are work as resin tappers, both in agroforestry and also as management staff. And the last is community capacity building. We conducted surrounding the kampung or villages around the Gunung Walat. This is our contribute to the sustainable development goal. You can explain shortly. Okay, next please. This is we fulfill the 13 and 15 goals of SDG. This is climate action and life of land, because as we know, before we planted, there is a bare land, yeah, only dominated by white grass or alang-alang. And with our student, our lecturer, have activity to plant the trees. The climate also changed after several years. You can see in the figure in 1982 it's still brown, and after 2007 it's already green. Okay, you can see in 1982 it's dominated mostly by alang-alang, but and also barren land, and we planted by agassiz stand on several hectares, and we start rehabilitation as our duty for all of our students to plant the trees. Okay, next please. This is the condition now. Already covered by several trees. Almost 30 species already planted several the example of the stem of the trees, including agatis, pine, puspa, African wood, mahogany, ratamala, rosewood, molukan, saw or jinjing, and mangyum. The picture. We can see the real forest already done by our student 30 years ago. It's a good condition if you have opportunity to visit. We are very welcome. Okay, next. And also biodiversity is 4.3%. We conducted the identification, preservation, research and education and monitoring about the flora and fauna that we interest in the one book. This is we have you can see in the wild animal also coming to the forest. This is support the 13 and 15 SDG for climate action and life of land. Okay, next. Gunung Walat Educational Forest also support to SDG number 1, number 2, and number 5. No poverty, zero hunger, and gender equality. There is some activities doing by local community involved in forest management to meet their daily household needs and jobs, like we pine paper 90%, copal paper 8%, manage staff 12%, and also the feeding livestock, firewood gather for fuel, food cellar, and also bamboo handicraft that use the resources from the local people surrounding the Gunung Walat Forest. Okay, next. This is also support 1 and 2 for the no poverty and zero hunger. We have agroforestry activities. The participant is 70 households, and the commodities of the agroforestry is banana, corn, coffee, ginger, turmeric, cardamom, cassava, etc. This is the location of the agroforestry activities. Okay, next. And also we support to the number 4, this is SDG number 4 is quality education. We facilitate education for Indonesian and foreign students to have some summer course activity training for senior and junior students from Indonesia and also from higher education also. Okay, next. Gunung Walat Educational Forest also support number 2 and number 6, zero hunger and clean water sanitation. Because after 30 years, Gunung Walat can produce the spring. Yeah. Five spring already produced for local community. Fresh water supply for household and fresh water supply for agriculture activity and fresh water supply for management needed. This is the condition of our forest. We have some facilities to water resources can be utilized by the people surrounding the Gunung Walat. Okay, next please. This is we support also for number 17, partnership for the goals. Yeah. The program is forest rehabilitation for increasing carbon sequestration with the company. Yeah, that we plan together and measure the carbon that and the plan is a several plan, and we plan together and maintain until the trees grow well. Okay, next. This is also an example that planting area for forest rehabilitation program to increase carbon sequestration by CSR program from Tosho, ConocoPhillips, and Waitai as a green company. Okay, next. And we have also collaboration with several national and foreign university from ASEAN countries and over the world. Okay, next.
I'm sorry, Professor.
Yes.
Dr. Naraswara, I'm sorry, but the sound is a little bit humming.
Okay.
Maybe the microphone. Yes.
Okay. It's okay.
Yeah. Now it's okay.
Yeah. For concluding remark that Gunung Walet Educational Forest is small-scale forest management model for enhancing educational and researchers in forestry and environment. Gunung Walet also provide a unique example of success story of transforming the bare land into forested land and how the forest management can survive without cutting the trees, while it continues provide environmental and social benefit. Carbon Gunung Walet Forest as doing a carbon project as a voluntary scheme that relevant with the scope of REDD, reduction emission and degradation forestry, and could be replicated in other area for implementing voluntary domestic carbon. And also from private company, especially in Indonesia, Gunung Walet Forest are also contributing to the achievement of SDG program, even though the contribution is very small, but we have been able to do according to our capacity. And Gunung Walet is an ideal place for promoting researches of multiple utilization of forests. And from this presentation, we conclude that we just contribute to 8 requirement SDGs. It's number 1, number 2, number 5, number 6, 13, 15, and 17. Finally, I do hope that my sharing today can be beneficial for all of you, especially for lovely student from 7 countries. Thank you very much. I enjoyed the scientific atmosphere of the summer course and have unforgettable moments with us here while expanding your knowledge and networking. I hope even with the virtual method, the goals and benefit of this summer course can be achieved. Thank you for your kind attention and consideration. Billahi taufik wal hidayah. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you very much, Professor Naraswara. The last presentation will be from Professor Ujang, followed by discussion about the topic brought by our Dean and Vice Dean. For all of you that already have a question, maybe the comparison between the situation in your country and Indonesia, please drop down the question in the chat section. Also for Dr. Afra and Associate Professor Naraswara, we hope you still remain here, because after the discussion, maybe we will have a photo session together. Thank you. Please welcome Professor Ujang. The time is yours.
Okay, thank you. Dear student and all the audience, we have just heard Professor Nareswaro and Afra describe about how the natural resources. So before I have some discussion about that, I would like to see your idea about, yeah, so what does the natural resources contribute to the human development? If you can write down for 2 or 3 sentences, please write down all of you in the chats, yeah? After you listen to the Professor Afra presentation and Dr. Nareswaro, Professor Nareswaro, please, what is your idea about how is the natural resources contribute for the human development? Please share your idea. Okay, I'm waiting for 2 or 3 minutes. Yeah. Just type 1 or 2 sentence, yeah. In your mind, what are the contribution, yeah, the natural resources for the human development? Yeah, please type your idea. Okay, good. From Kumar, Malaysia. Thank you, your idea. Okay, please. Okay, Kathleen, Philippines. Okay. Yeah, it's a good idea, yeah. Intervene with the human development because we should ensure that they utilize these resources without abusing them. That's a good idea. Okay. Another idea? Yes. We care about the future generation. Okay. Another. Please, other participant, write it 2 or 3 sentences. Okay, another idea, that's interesting. Yeah. Okay, while I'm preparing my presentation for... Okay. Okay, share your idea. Okay, good. Thank you, Chief from India, Azam. Yeah, from Indonesia. Thank you from your idea. Okay, Prema. Okay, another idea, please. Okay, I'm waiting for your idea. Okay. Okay, one or two minutes. I'm waiting for your idea. Okay, if we talk about the human development, if we talk about the human, okay, thank you from Nole, from Singapore. Yeah. That the human lives in the community. Okay. As we understand, live in the community. And where is the community? So they are living in the family. So family is a medium, is a social unit where the human will develop. And this family depends on the natural resources. And also the natural resources influence the family. So the family and the human development inside the family playing major roles in sustainability. So if we fail to look at the family and the individual inside the family, then we are not able to sustain our natural resources. So I think this is the basic idea. The basic idea. So when you talk about the human development and how the important the natural resources. So the family influence the resources, and also natural resources influence the family. So what are the ability? So what are the competency that the family and all the member should have? So this is what I call the basic competency that everybody, each individual in the family, and also the family, they have the capability, they have to have an ability for family resource management to manage the resources, because the natural resources where the family lives are the family resources. Then to be sustained, they have to have an ability to manage these resources. Okay, thank you from Debbie, also from Malaysia. Natural resources are important civilization. Okay, that's a good idea. We live in natural resources. That's right, yeah. I think the natural resources can be capital for the human development. That's right, yeah. The natural resources are the most significant capital. So then we have to learn the basic management, because the success and the value to sustain our natural resources depend significantly how our ability to manage the resources. And I think I'm really very pleased that Faculty of Forestry of IPB successfully, you know, make the forest become green again. Yeah. In 82, we look at the lands are very bare, you know, no tree planted on that area. But during the 87, 97, it changed very dramatically. So why we have to have the ability to manage? Okay, human protect nature, nature protect human. That's good. Yeah, it's from Della Riza. The resources is limited. But more and more people and more family lives. And these natural resources have to support the family needs and individual needs. That's why the idea is how to manage our resources. So what are the basic process? What are the management process basic? Yeah. We have to identify our problem, our need, our want, and our goal. And this will influence our value. Then we have to identify resources. After we identify resources, then we have to make decision. We have to make a plan, and then we have to implement. Then we have to accomplish our goals and evaluate that our goals. Assume that all people depends on their environment or close natural environment. Let's say our yard, our backyard. We cannot buy food from outside the family. Then we have more problem, because not all family members, not all individual have the capability, have the ability to plan. So that's why we have to collaborate to each other. Some family become farmers and other become consumer. So this is what I call by how we manage our natural resources, by providing delegation of authority, delegation of jobs, and delegation of work. So this is the beauty of the management process. Okay, I think a lot of some students now have an idea about, yeah. So the basic idea for the management is we have to understand our need and we have to understand our want. And Professor Afra has described about tourism. I think tourism destination is one of our needs, yeah, because tourism will provide us with the emotional feeling, emotional satisfaction by looking at the land, the beautiful forest, then our emotional need will be accomplished. We have needs and we have wants. Sometimes the same need fulfilled by different want. Yeah. And of course, natural resources will provide more different want, different needs. Yeah, different product, different services to meet our different want. When we meet our need or want, sometimes we have problem. Yeah, we have dilemma because we need food, and sometimes we have to expand our farming, and sometimes we sacrifice some of our forest. So this is the major dilemma. So we have to have some balance between problem, yeah, between need, wants, and our goals. So this is the basic idea of our management system. Yeah. The value are very important. So our summer course program right now, yeah, we will have some discussion about the importance of the value to be with the sustainability. Without sustainability, without understanding the concept of sustainability, then we have problem with our future. So that's why we understand that you are, as the young generation, will be the agent of change to educate community, to educate people, larger society, how important is the sustainability. So by spreading our value of sustainability, then we will have respect. We will have some respect to our natural resources. And our natural resources will be sustained for our future generation. So this is my first discussion about the human development and sustainability. We would like to thank you to all of you who has written the idea about the relationship between natural resources and human development. Thank you very much. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.